Dai Taguchi from Japan, Okayama. In this presentation, I would like to talk about multidimensional extension of the estimate proved by Avikainen. This is the estimate. And then I will consider some application of the estimate to numerical analysis for a solution of stochastic differential equations. In my presentation, I will also give an idea to extend Avikainen's estimate on some metric measure spaces. This is the outline of my talk. First, I will show the motivation and the original Avikainen's estimate. Then I will provide its multidimensional extension. Then I will give the idea of the proof. For the proof, there is two ideas. The first idea is to use the Hardy-Littrott maximal function and its estimate, which is famous in the field of real analysis and harmonic analysis. The second idea is to use the pointwise estimate for bounded variation function, which is some characterization of the class of bounded variation. Then we will apply main statement to the numerical analysis for a solution to SDE based on the multi-level Monte Carlo method, and also apply it to study L2 time regularity of the backward stochastic differential equation. So I will start from the motivation of this research. So we consider the stochastic differential equation driven by Brownian motion B here. Then the problem is how to compute the probability of the process X capital T which stay in the domain D. To compute this probability, we often use the Euler-Mariam scheme as numerical scheme of SDE. So it is defined by this equation. Here, the eta h, the division points of the closed interval, 0 capital T. If we suppose the coefficient p and sigma are bounded and smooth, and the diffusion coefficient is uniformly elliptic, then it is known that for any bounded measurable function f, the weak error is estimated above by the size of time step h. This can be applied to usual Monte Carlo method, and thus we can compute this property. On the other hand, in this talk, we are interested in the strong rate of convergence, or LQ rate of convergence, for the Euler-Mariam scheme. And here f is some irregular function. It means f is an indicator function or a bounded variation. The strong rate of convergence can be applied to use the multi-level Monte Carlo method to reduce the computational complexity, which is the motivation of this research. Now I will explain the original estimate proved by Avikainen. I'll first review the definition of bounded variation in R. For a measurable function f, we define the total variation function TF by the supremum of sum of the difference of the function F. The supremum is this supremum is taken over all n and all partitions, and the x0 does not fix. Then the function f is said to be a function of bounded variation if the limit of tf denoted by vf is finite. And then we call vf the total variation of f. For example, these indicator functions and more generally bounded and monotone function are bounded variation. And the, by definition, by with this definition, we can prove the function f is bounded. Then Avikainen proved this estimate. Let x be a one-dimensional random variable with bounded density px, and x hat is any one-dimensional random variable. And f is a function of bounded variation. And p and q are the parameter greater than or equal to 1. For p and q, there is no relation. There is no relation between p and q. Then Avikainen showed that the q's moment of the difference between f of x and f of x hat can be estimated above by some constant depend on the total variation of f here and the upper bound of the density function here and the expectation of the piece moment of the difference between x and x hat to the power 1 divided by p plus 1. The point is that on the right hand side of the expectation here, this is the 1 divided by p plus 1. It is not 1 divided by p. Which means that the right-hand side is not LP norm. It is also shown that this estimate is optimal. Optimal, it means the equality holds for some random variable x and x hat. So here is equal for some x and x hat and f. As I explained, the motivation of this estimate is to apply multi-level Monte Carlo method to compute the binary option. It is indicator payoff function. And this estimate can be also applied to study regularity of a solution of backward stochastic differential equations. For the proof, there are three ideas. The first idea is to apply a Skolopoutsov representation of the random variable x. For embedding to this probability space, it means that this random variable x star defined by the left inverse of distribution function of fx, then it can be shown that x and x star has the same distribution. And there are many good properties. This is the first idea. The second idea of the proof is Lipschitz continuity of the distribution function. it is equivalent to the boundedness of the density function. The third idea is that the proof of the estimate, Avikainen's estimate for the indicator function on some half interval, and then extend to the function f with some integral form with respect to some measure nu. These are the idea of the proof. Recently, Giles and Sharp give a simpler proof for the Avikainen's estimate in the case of the indicator function. So there is a remark. So for multi-dimensional random variables, we also have a Skolhoff embedding theorem. But it might be difficult to apply such a theorem for extending Avikainen's estimate in the multi-dimensional setting, because this representation does not have explicit form. So we need to consider the other idea for extending the Avikainen's estimate to multi-dimensional setting. Now I will review the definition of function of bounded variation in RD, multi-dimensional setting. Okay, so let U be an open subset of RD. Then we say the function f is bounded variation on U. If the function f is L1 function on U and the supremum of this, the integral of f times the divergence of g. G is a smooth function with a smooth and bounded function. So this supremum is finite, then we call f is a function of bounded variation on U. In one-dimensional setting case, this definition has some relation to previous definition of the function bounded variation, which is almost equivalent. Then by using the structure theorem of bounded variation in U, there exists a vector valued random measure. Vector value random measure on U such that for the integral in the supremum here, the divergence operator of G can be moved to F. So, which means a kind of generalized integration bypass formula. And the DF is a kind of generalized gradient of the function f. And for a bounded variation function f on U, as formal notation, we define the integral on U of the absolute value of the gradient df. It is defined by this supremum. Then this integral is the total variation of the function f in U. It is, we also define locally bounded variation on U. It is the L1 local function with the total variation df is finite for all open subset V of U, and V is the closure of V is a compact on U. Compact on compact and subset of U. For example, the Sobolev space W11 is a subset of class of bounded variation on RT. Because when the Radon measure DF here is absolutely continuous with respect to the Lebesgue measure, then this integration by parts formula is the definition of the Sobolev space. Moreover, the subspace E with C2 boundary, then the indicator function of this indicator function of this subspace E is a function of bounded variation in RT. This is the example. So now I will give the main statement of this talk as the multidimensional extension of the Avikainen estimate. Okay, so let X be a d-dimensional random variable with bounded density Px, and X hat is any d-dimensional random variable. But in this case, we need the existence of density function of the random variable X hat, Px hat. But we do not need to assume boundedness for Px hat. And F is a function of bounded variation in RD. And we must assume it is bounded. And P and Q are the parameter greater than or equal to 1. There's no relation between P and Q. Then we have the same estimate, same Avikainen's estimate with some constant C. I will show explicit form for this constant later. So as I explained, the motivation of this estimate is to apply the multi-level Monte Carlo method for some indicator function. And this can be also applied to study some regularity of backward stochastic differential equation. And in this case, the power 1 divided by p plus 1, it is also optimal. For the optimality, we can construct a random variable x and x hat by choosing the uniformly distributed random variables on 0,1. And we also define x hat by using some given epsilon. Then by choosing some function f belongs to bounded variation in RD, we can prove that the equality holds for the Avikainen's estimate. It's the meaning of the optimality. From here, I will explain the idea of the proof for multidimensional version of Avikainen's estimate. As I explained, it is difficult to use the idea of the one-dimensional setting, so we need to consider some new ideas. The first idea of the proof is to use the Hardy-Littrell maximal function and its estimate. Okay, so we first use the integral with bar, as the average of the function f, average of the function f on the ball, bx s with center x and radius s, then hard-little maximum operator M is defined by the supremum over S of the average of the function F on the ball. And more generally, this operator can be defined for a locally finite vector valued measure mu on RT by the same way. Here, the absolute value of the measure nu is the total variation of the measure nu. And if we write the MR, then it is the restricted Hard-Little maximum function, which means the supremum is taken for S less than capital R here. Then for Hard-Little maximum function, we have a weak type estimate, which states that there exists a constant A1 such that for any finite Borel measure nu on RD and positive number lambda, the Lebesgue measure of M nu greater than lambda, this can be estimated above by some constant A1, and the total variation of measure nu and lambda to the power minus 1. This means the tail is small, and the constant A1 can be chosen 5 to the power dimension d. Okay, there is a remark. When p greater than 1, we have LP estimate for the maximum function. This is called the strong type estimate. So the idea of the proof of lemma 1, Hard-Little maximum estimate, weak type estimate, it is based on the Vitali's covering lemma, which states here, and and moreover, this Vitali's covering lemma is true for any separable metric spaces. And so the first idea to use the Hard-Little weak type estimate can be also applied in order to prove Avikainen's estimate on some metric measure spaces. And the second idea is the pointwise estimate for the class of locally grounded variation. Okay, so let F be a locally bounded variation in RD. Then we have a kind of local Lipschitz type estimate. It means that on the complement of the Lebesgue null set N, N is Lebesgue null set, on this set, the difference between f of x and f of y can be estimated above by some constant k0 and x minus y and the Hard-Little maximum operator of the generalized gradient Radon measure df restricted on 2 times x minus y. So the idea of the proof is to use the Poincaré inequality for the function bounded variation and Lebesgue differentiation theorem. The point here is that in the right hand side here, we have the Hardy-Littles maximum function m df of x, not y. There's no y here. So, and this is the reason why we only assume the boundedness for the density function for the random variable x. So there's a remark. So by using the same way as a proof, we have similar estimate. Here there is a in the right hand side here has the both m of df of x and m df of y, both x and y. There's both x and y. But by using similar pointwise estimate for, okay, so there is a characterization for the subrest space W1P. So this is a similar pointwise estimate for some LP integrable function G. Then using this pointwise estimate, the subrest space W1P is characterized. It means this estimate is equivalent to the function f belongs to the subrest space W1P. So using this pointwise estimate, subrest space or metric space is defined in this in these two papers. Moreover, Ratti and Tuominen characterized class of bounded variation in RT by using this pointwise estimate. And then they define class of bounded variation on metric measure space with some doubling property. It is this doubling property. So the second idea to use a pointwise estimate can be also applied in order to prove the Avikainen estimate on some metric measure space. Then, by using the Hardy-Littles maximum function and its estimate, and pointwise estimate, we first prove multidimensional Avikainen estimate for the indicator function. Okay, so the point here is that the constant here has the explicit representation. And there is the total variation of the generalized gradient of the indicator function 1e. So in the proof of this lemma, I will explain the reason why the parameter p and q has no relation and p and q can be chosen arbitrarily. This is a proof. This is the proof of lemma 3. So if this expectation equal to 0, then x equal to x hat almost surely, so the statement is trivial. So now I will assume that this expectation is strictly positive. I first use the important trick why there is no relation between P and Q. For any P and Q, the difference between the indicator function to the power Q and the indicator function to the power P, these are the equal. So by using this trick, we have that the expectation with power q is equal to the expectation to the power p. Expectation of the difference of the indicator function to the power p. So we can choose p and q arbitrarily. Then the expectation can be separated to two parts here. The first term. Is the expectation on the event here, event omega of the Hardy-Little root maximum function m1e of the of x is greater than lambda for given for some lambda. We will choose lambda later. On this event, because the random variable x has bounded density, so using the so this expectation is less than this probability, and x has density, so we have this integral form, and the p, the density p is bounded, so then we then by using the Hardy-Little root maximum weak type estimate, we have this estimate. So the, this is the estimate for the first term. Okay, so for the second term, on the complement event omega, complement event of the omega, we will use the pointwise estimate. Because both x and x hat has a probability density function, so that this, the expectation on this complement event is equal with x and x hat belongs to the complement of the null state n defined in the lemma 2. So by using the pointwise estimate, the difference between the these indicator functions are estimated above by the difference between x and x hat to the power p with Hardy-Little root maximum MD1E of x to the power p. But on this event, the Hardy-Little root maximum function is bounded above by lambda. So it can be, this can be moved out to the expectation here. So we get this estimate. If we use the usual pointwise estimate 8 here, both x and y, then in this expectation, there is also md1e of x hat to the power p. Then in order to move out to the expectation, we need the boundedness for the density function of the random variable x hat for the estimate of the first part, first term. So anyway, we have this estimate, lambda inverse plus lambda to the power p with some expectation, with expectation of the x difference between x and x hat to the power p. Then by choosing lambda as the expectation to the power minus 1 divided by p plus 1, then we obtain the Avikainen's estimate for the indicator function. So this is a proof of the statement. Then I remind the main statement of multidimensional version of Avikainen's estimate. This is a reminder. So from here, I will show the proof of this theorem by using the estimate, the Avikainen's estimate in the case of the indicator function. So for any real number t, we define the set ET by this. Then it is known that the indicator function of the set ET is a function of bounded variation in RT, almost every t. And then the difference between f of x and f of y can be written by the integral of the difference of the indicator function ET. So then by using the Jensen's inequality, we have this estimate because of the boundedness of the function f. So then this expectation is the difference between the indicator functions of x and of x hat to the power q. So we can apply Avikainen's estimate for the indicator function proved in the previous lemma. So then we obtain this estimate here. So then to conclude the statement, we have to estimate the integral with respect to t of the total variation of the gradient of the indicator function 1 et. We need to estimate this integral with respect to t, but this can be computed by using the coarea formula for bounded variation function. It is a kind of Hubini's type theorem. Then we conclude this part is equal to the total variation of the gradient of f. Then we conclude the statement. Now I would like to talk on the application of the Avikainen's estimate. For applying the estimate, we need the upper bound of the boundedness of the density function. There are two examples. So first example shows that is a conclusion of the Levy's inversion formula. So let x be a random variables, and if the characteristic function phi x belongs to the L1 function, then the Levy's inversion formula shows that the random variable x admits the bounded and continuous density function. So in this case, we can use the Avikainen's estimate. Next example shows that the Gaussian two-sided bound for the density function of the solution of stochastic differential equation. So we consider the SDE driven by Brownian motion B. We suppose that the drift coefficient B is bounded and measurable, and the diffusion coefficient sigma satisfy these two conditions. The first condition is the function A defined by this is alpha Hilda continuous with alpha belongs to 0 to from 0 to 1. And the second condition is the diffusion coefficient sigma is bounded and uniformly elliptic. It means the matrix A satisfies this condition. Then it can be shown that for all t greater than 0, less than capital T, less than equal to capital T, the x of xt admits the density function ptx. X is the initial value of the solution. The density ptx, there exists a density function with respect to Lebesgue measure, and it satisfies Gaussian two-sided bound. Here g, the function g here, is the density function of normal distribution defined by this. And so the density of the solution with SD, XD, is bounded with respect to Y. So we can use a multi-dimensional Avikainen estimate. Then by using the Avikainen estimate and Gaussian upper bound for the density, we have the strong rate of convergence for the Euler-Maria scale. So let XH be the Euler-Maria scheme, and we suppose that the coefficient B and sigma of the SDE is the bounded and Lipschitz continuous. And the diffusion coefficient sigma is uniformly elliptic. And this implies that the XHT has a density function, so which satisfies the assumption of the Avikainen estimate, main statement. Then, for any function bounded variation f and q and delta, the q's moment of the difference between f of x and f of xh at capital T to the power q is estimated above by some constant times the size of time step h to the power delta divided by 2. For the proof, the assumption of the Lipschitz continuity of the coefficient, there exists a constant C such that the LP for any P LP rate of LP rate of convergence is 1/2. So applying the Avikainen's estimate and Gaussian upper bound for the density of the SDE, we obtain this estimate for any p. So by choosing p as delta divided by 1 minus delta, then we conclude this estimate. And this estimate can be applied to use the multi-level Monte Carlo method in order to reduce the computational complexity. So then finally, I will apply Avikainen's estimate to study L2 time regularity of backward stochastic differential equation. So we consider the Markovian type decoupled forward backward stochastic differential equation. Here, so we suppose the some good condition on the coefficient B and sigma and driver F, and some integrability for the terminal function G. Here G is the irregular function. So then for a given time mesh pi, we define L2 time regularity of Z, epsilon Z pi. It is defined by some expectation of this time integral. And here Z bar is a conditional expectation on some small interval. Then so for providing the estimate of epsilon Z pi, Gobe and McLuff define the space L to alpha defined by this. Then it is shown that if the terminal function G belongs to this L to alpha and the Ti minus Ti minus 1 equal to T divided by N, then epsilon Z pi is estimated by constant times N to the power minus alpha. This estimate can be applied to some convergence of the numerical schemes for backward stochastic differential equations. By using this fact and Avikainen's estimate, we consider the estimate of the epsilon Z pi if the terminal function G is a function of unwanted variation. So we suppose the assumption 1 and the terminal function G is a bounded variation, unbounded. So then, and we consider the time mesh pi is the same size, so t divided by n. Then for any delta, there exists C delta such that the epsilon Z pi is estimated above by constant times n to the power minus delta divided by 2. For this proof, we use the Gaussian upper bound for the transition density function of the circuit forward process x. So under the assumption 1, the forward equation x admits a forward process x is a Markov process, and x admits a transition probability density function P of S x T y, and it satisfies Gaussian upper bound. Then by using the Markov property of the forward process X, this expectation can be written by using transition density function P. And then by using the Jensen's inequality and Avikainen's estimate, we obtain the estimate constant times capital T minus small t to the power p divided by 2p plus 1. So then, by choosing p by the delta divided by 1 minus delta, we conclude the proof of this estimate. So this is the end of my presentation. If you have any question and comments, please send me an email. So thank you very much for your listening.